Dear students, good morning. This is Dr. Nevin Nabil Mustafa, Professor of Hematology, Oncology and Bone Marrow Transplantation. Our topic today is about lymphadenopathy. By the end of this lecture, you should be able to study the distribution of lymph nodes in the body, know the different causes of lymphadenopathy and discriminate between them, study the clinical picture of lymphadenopathy, and how to proceed to investigate a case with lymphadenopathy. Humans have approximately 500 to 600 lymph nodes distributed throughout the body, with clusters found in the underarms, groin, neck, chest, and abdomen. And these are named lymph nodes. Lymph nodes in conjunction with the spleen, tonsils, adenoids, and Peyer's patch are highly organized centers of immune cells that filter antigen from the extracellular fluid. Here is the structure of a lymph node. As you see, there is an afferent lymphatic vessel in which the lymph flow inside the lymph node. There is a valve to prevent the backflow. The lymph flow throughout the lymph node and go out from the efferent lymphatic vessel. The lymph node is a ovoid or kidney-shaped organ that is widely present throughout the body. They are linked to the lymphatic vessels by the lymphatic vessels to the circulatory system. The lymph node is enclosed in a fibrous capsule and is made up of an outer cortex and an inner medulla. The substance of the lymph node is divided into outer cortex and inner medulla. Beta cells are mainly found in the outer superficial cortex, where they are clustered together as follicles, forming lymphoid follicles. And the T cells are mainly in the paracortex. So, what is meant by lymphadenopathy? It is a disease of lymph node in which they are abnormal in size, number, or consistency. It may be localized or generalized. Lymphadenopathy is a common and non-specific sign. What are the causes of lymphadenopathy? It can be classified into localized, or in other words, regional, or it may be generalized. In localized lymphadenopathy, there is enlargement of a single group of lymph node or multiple contiguous nodal regions. The generalized lymphadenopathy, there is enlargement of more than one non-contiguous lymph node groups. Here is the distribution of lymph nodes in the body. We have cervical group, axillary group, mediastinal, epitrochlear, mesenteric, paraaortic, inguinal, and popliteal. Those groups that we can palpate and examine during the clinical examination are the cervical group, in which there is a horizontal and vertical, the axillary group, the epitrochlear, and the inguinal and the popliteal groups. These groups can be detected clinically by palpation. The mediastinal group can be also detected by the clinical examination in the form of bronchial breathing below T2 spine during auscultation. If you hear a bronchial breathing below T2, this means that there is a mediastinal lymph node enlargement. What is the etiology of lymphadenopathy? Lymph nodes are concentrated in the head, neck, axilla, mediastinum, abdomen. Each group drains lymph from a particular region of the body. We named it the draining area. So, in cases in which there is increased size of a lymph node, we have to search for a cause in the draining area. Knowledge of the pattern of lymph drainage aids in determining the etiology. As regards the etiology of generalized lymphadenopathy, the most common cause is actually infections. It is either associated with systemic viral infection, example infectious mononucleosis, cytomegalovirus, herpes virus, and HIV. Some bacterial infection present with generalized lymphadenopathy as typhoid fever, salmonella, and tuberculosis, which is a mycobacterium. There is malignant etiologies in which the malignancy is present either in the lymph node itself as a hematological malignancy, or it is complication or metastasis from a malignancy elsewhere. Malignancy is often associated with its constitutional signs such as fever, anorexia, non-specific aches, weight loss, and night sweats. The acute leukemias and lymphoma often present with these non-specific findings. Some storage diseases are characterized by generalized lymphadenopathy in which there is deposition of certain materials, like in Niemann-Pick disease, sphingomyelin and other lipids accumulate in the spleen, liver, and lymph node. In Gaucher's disease, the accumulation of glucosyl ceramide leads to the engorgement of the spleen, liver, lymph nodes, and bone marrow. Sometimes generalized lymphadenopathy is due to drug reaction. The most common known drug to cause a generalized lymphadenopathy is phenytoin. Some patients experience a syndrome of regional of generalized lymphadenopathy followed by a severe maculopapular rash, fever, hepatosplenomegaly, jaundice, and anemia. Other drugs like allopurinol used in treatment of gout and INH or isoniazid used in the treatment of tuberculosis. Other non-neoplastic etiologies include histiocytosis and Epstein-Barr-associated lymphoproliferative diseases. Among the autoimmune etiologies, there is the juvenile rheumatoid arthritis, which often presents with adenopathy, especially in the acute phases of the disease. Also, sarcoidosis is common presenting. One of its common presenting features is lymphadenopathy, which may be either localized or generalized, and this depends upon the stage of the sarcoid disease. As regards regional lymphadenopathy, it involves enlargement of a single node or multiple contiguous nodal region. It also may be of infectious etiology. Usually, the cervical lymph nodes are enlarged in cases of viral infections as infectious mononucleosis, cytomegalovirus, or others, and sometimes bacterial infection, recurrent infection in the throat or tonsils due to staphylococci, streptococci. Also, mycobacterium tuberculosis may present as localized enlargement of the lymph node. Mediastinal lymphadenopathy is usually a sign of serious underlying lung disease. This kitten is very cute, isn't it? But there is a danger of transmitting a disease known as cat scratch disease. It is caused by Bartonella organism presents with subacute lymphadenopathy, often in the cervical region. The disease develops after the infected pet, usually a kitten, inoculates the host, usually through a scratch. Approximately 30 days later, fever, headache, malaise develop along with adenopathy that is often tender. Several lymph node chains may be involved. As regards non-infectious etiology of the regional lymphadenopathy, it may be malignant or malignancy in the organ drained by this group of lymph node, or autoimmune disease or granulomatous infiltration. What about the clinical picture? This of course depends on the cause of lymphadenopathy and the site of the group enlarged. In most cases of generalized lymphadenopathy, there is hepatomegaly and or splenomegaly. What about the laboratory investigations? The following studies should be considered for chronic lymphadenopathy, that means if persists more than 3 weeks. We have to do a complete blood count, LDH and uric acid, test for the cat scratch disease by serological method, search for TB, viral markers and autoimmune markers, aiming to know the cause of the enlarged lymph node. As regards the imaging studies, chest X-ray may be helpful in elucidating mediastinal adenopathy and the underlying disease affecting lung, including TB. CT chest, abdomen or both is also valuable. MRI can be used to differentiate malignant from benign mediastinal lymphadenopathy. Another imaging tool that is PET scan or positron emission tomography is not helpful as a screening tool, as benign and malignant condition may cause intense uptake. However, PET scan is helpful in the staging of lymphomas once a diagnosis is made and also in the follow-up. Sometimes ultrasonography may be helpful in documenting the extent of lymph node involvement and any change in the lymph node. This is a normal PET scan. There is uptake in the heart, the kidneys, and the bladder. This is a PET scan before and after treatment. As you see, before treatment, there is multiple uptake of the radio-labeled material, and then after chemotherapy, you see that there is no more uptake. Another tool to diagnose a case of lymphadenopathy is biopsy. The critical question is often whether or not to perform a lymph node biopsy. This requires an overall assessment of the history and physical examination. There are many types of biopsy. The excisional biopsy is the best. Sometimes we are obliged to take fine needles. Fine needle and core needle biopsy yield small samples with limited ability to perform flow cytometry and chromosomal analysis. And the histologic findings depend on the underlying etiology. Staging is relevant only when a specific malignancy is diagnosed as the etiology of lymphadenopathy. This is involvement of lymph nodes in Hodgkin disease by percentage. I mean that in Hodgkin's disease, in 75% may be localized to only one group. As you can see, head and neck, supraclavicular, axillary, inguinal, or it may be generalized as first presentation in 25% of cases. This also shows staging of Hodgkin's disease. There is four stages for involvement of lymph nodes according to the site of the group affected. Treatment is determined, of course, by the specific underlying etiology of lymphadenopathy. Please be ready with your questions in the next face-to-face session, and thank you very much.